afternoon, everyone. I am Marianne. I am a second-year student from BAE po. Before I proceed to my question, I would like to welcome you to UP Mindanao po and congratulations on your achievement. So, an argument discussed in one of our classes this semester was all about the measurement of validity of writers who aren't exactly from this place, but are writing for this place. Considering that we are talking about local histories and solid memories of this place, what are your thoughts po about writers writing on behalf of the people of this place, example in Pasay? And how can we make sure that they don't stain local history? Example po, for those people, for those writers who are not exactly from Pasay, but are writing for Pasay. So how can we make sure po that they don't stain local histories and yun?
Okay, yes. You know, when we were organizing this event, no, I called up Joy one morning. I said, Joy, makakakuha ba tayo ng audience? Kasi summer ito. And then you're in Mindanao. And your experience of Yolanda, I think is different, no, than for those who were in that place, no, Region A. And for me as well, when I was in Manila, no? Kahapon, I think it was Jade, no? Capiñanos, who said na he actually felt a sense of guilt, no? Kasi he didn't know how to react, no? When the like, a good part of our country was dealing with the loss, no? Parang hindi naman daw ata kayo naapektuhan dito. Just wind or what, no? Or gray clouds, ganyan, no? So it's always difficult to say that you are writing for a people. Ako, I do not have such lofty ideals, no? Kasi nakakatakot siya, no? When you say that I am writing for, no? I was very clear with my motivations, no, for writing the book. And that is, simply put, I was so much affected by what happened during Yolanda, by what I saw on TV when the first instance of news, no, came out, and of course the coverage, the continuing recovery, and I had really in the immediate family, no, they had losses. No, they lost certain members of their family to Yolanda. And I have a sister-in-law who originally comes from Pasay, no, and whose family is still staying in Pasay. She described their journey, their trek to Pasay right after Yolanda. She was telling me that they had to hire, that they had to rent, no, yung jeepney, and talagang an overnight land trip. And when they got na, when they arrived in Pasay, they had to walk, no? And they were stepping over people's bodies, no? Because it took a while, no, for government, substantial government assistance to come in and started, you know, gathering all the corpses, no? So ganun ka, ano, talaga, visceral, no, yung ano. As I said, no, It was for my own sense of, I don't know, siguro identity, no, that I started looking into the history of Pasay, and I felt that we can actually do this in our own, ano, you do not need to go out and write a book, no, unless that is really what you want, no, but if there is anything that can come out, no, of the book, like for instance this exchange, no, that we're having right now, you might be inspired to write about places here, no, that are close, that you feel, you know, are very meaningful to your life, no, as a young person, then do so, no. Yung ano ng local history, in fact, in the book, I was questioning the very notion of local history, no? why do you call it local history? No, is there really such a place that is local? No, and I am, of course, I know the distinction, no, in historical discourse, the national history versus the local, no. And again, it is giving a hierarchy, no, to certain knowledge, no. But as I said, like for instance, in Pasay, because that's a coastal town, so it's water. No, people live with water. No, water is their life. Okay, the sea is their life. The ocean is their life. So anything that has water running through it can never be local, can never be static, because the currents move, and with it, there is always the chance that new things will take place. Kaya nga nagkaroon siya ng training before, di ba? And that training connects it to the wider, no, Southeast Asian region, no? At least that's what I have read in the archives, no? I don't know, siguro tataas ang kilay ng mga historians with my subversion of the term local history. But we can always naman question these terminologies, di ba? I think that's I don't know if I answered your question.
Yes, well, thank you so much, Prof.
But always there is I think part of our, maybe a minimum requirement is really for you to do research. For you to do research. Ako kasi nauna yung imaginative dealings ko with Pasay without me knowing that it's actually Pasay that I was writing about, no. And then later I did the hard research, no. Because that's, I think you owe that to your readers as well.
Thank you so much, Prof.
Thank you so much for that. Are there any other questions from the audience?
Ano lang po, since yung topic niyo po is about a place and about your home, parang how do you choose po kung anong material from your home yung gagamitin niyo po sa inyong when you write po? Like, saan po kayo nagbe-base? Tapos, paano niyo po in-arrange yung book niyo based on your
Very good question. Oo, maraming salamat. Oo. So, kasi it's really going into the book, no? Yung structural design, no? Structural design. Nani kaya ako, doon ako nahirapan. But I made sure, for instance, the first essay, no? Yung charting an inner map. When I finished that, yung charting an inner map, Pasay's Pumating Imagination, I revised that several times, no? And then I would put in additional materials, no? Whenever I feel na, this is not yet it, no? In fact, if you have yung the book, you would see maps there, no? Maps that has Pasay in it. And part of the reason why I wrote the book was to show how the conceptualizations of cartography has actually changed yung drawing ng Pasay, no, over time. So I had yung maps, I was able to access yung Library of Congress online, and they have wonderful collections of our Philippine maps. Pre-colonial, colonial, and then post-colonial, no? I mean, for that alone, you can do another book, no? Kasi parang sabi ko nga ganun, wow. So, before, yung kay Murillo map, no, that actually was used, di ba, yung dyan sa ating South China Sea, na parang as proof that we actually own, no, the waters. Yung sa Murillo map, it would show yung Pasay na it's almost like talagang nakadikit siya sa Tacloban. Oh, and then it shows yung Samar. Samar is called Ibabaw at that time. Ibabaw as compared to the yung the upper and then the ano and the lower, no? The higher land and then the lower ano yung lower place, no? Kasi parang ang simple minsan kasi ngayon, 'di ba, we have the island, ano, yung the island, critical island studies, no? And then I figure out na maybe yung our sense of island is also so different, no? Or we can explore more our experience of the island. Kasi if you read the history of Samar, you have the people yung from the highlands and from the lower lands, no? The highlanders are actually very suspicious of the lower ano of the people there yung sa ano sa ground because they feel that they're always being taken advantage of in terms of their labors and in terms of their produce, no? So ang dami kong iniisip and in my continuous readings I wanted to put in everything, no? Kaya yun yung sabi ko, the maps has to be there because I need to show how the place have actually been visualized and drawn concretely onto maps, no? So may mga maps yung mga Amerikano showing the deployment of the military during the resistance, no? Tapos may maps nga na yung during yung sa Spanish and then you have also yung mga maps, disaster maps, no? So when I finally finished yung first chapter, I said, ah, okay na. I already have a theoretical anchor, no? Kasi in the first chapter, that was where I was defining home as physical, home as spiritual, home as psychical, no? And that is yung for humanist geographers, they are saying that place can only have meaning once you imbue it with experience, no? So parang ang dami kong ano, ang dami kong pinapasukan na ano, discipline, wala ko care, no? So parang talagang sabi ko, I will claim this interdisciplinary na kung interdisciplinary because you cannot actually naman use just one POV point of view for such a complex experience, no? So, parang ginugulo ko talaga yung utak ko. And pag nagugulo yung utak ko, parang gusto ko yung, parang you get to explore so many things. So, when I was finished with that, yung first essay, nanganak na lang nanganak siya. So, the second one was, I centered on home. I was zeroing in already on what I was feeling na yung experience ko. So, etymologies of home, and then my own story, basay, a story is told. And then you have yung, ano nga ba yung susunod na? Historical vignettes, and then you have Yolanda, and then you have, ano, metaphors of weaving. And so parang yun na, yung design ko is from the larger, no? The larger landscape, and then zeroing in on the personal, and then weaving, and then with the last, it's opening up the question of places, not only Pasay, but the places that we ourselves call home. So yun, yeah, sakit sa ulo.
Thank you for that, Ma'am Roma. Any more questions from the audience? Anyone would like to ask?
Hello po, good afternoon. I am Henry, also a second year BA English major. So, ang question ko po is, after writing about Yolanda, so a tragic event that entails death and grief, how, as a writer, do you, for the lack of better terms, separate or desensitize yourself from that para hindi ka makonsume ng overwhelming grief so that makakontinue ka mag-write? So, how did you do that in this book?
But I think grief would always consume you, and that's the function of grief, eh? And the only way that you can survive, the only way that you can survive it is really to yung see through the entire process, no, so that you can reclaim yourself at the other end of it, no? And maybe this is the way that I, you know, dealt with it, you know, to really write about, you know. Kasi even if I was, in between kasi, I was also able to come up with another book while I was writing yung, while I was struggling with Weaving Masai. I came up with yung We Shall Write Love Again, We Shall Write Love Poems Again, no? And I realized na yung with the books, sabi ko ang ganun, parang may kulang pa dito. Kasi in truth, I was already done with the manuscript back in 2018. That is why they cleared me. That's the reason why they cleared me na yung of all the yung requirements of the grant. NBDB gave me a certificate saying that this is already a publishable manuscript. You're done with the grant. Off ka na, no, of any accountability. But then I was holding on to it because I felt that this is not the kind of book that I would want to publish if I want to publish something about Masai. Because, yun na nga, parang ang feeling ko, I have already complied with the local history portion, but not with the poet's history of home. So when I started really giving it time, yung when I started my sabbatical back in September 2023, that was the only time that I really got to sit down. I said, what are the things that are lacking in this book that once I identify them will allow me to finish the book? So one is, I put the poetry back. As in, literally, I culled from my earlier works because I realized that this will clinch the connection. Kasi yung, di ba, I have been writing about it. And so what are these poems that will actually, you know, give the readers a sense that, oh, this is really about it, ganyan, and then can make the connection. So that's one thing that I did, and then I put in more photos because even if I am, you know, experiencing a place in a different way, it has to have a physical locality, eh, di ba? So yung the photos help, no? And then also yung the maps. So when I had it all, sabi ko, ah, okay na. And even the way that I made the citations, kasi talagang I really just put in everything of my process there. So I had a citation na parang which says na, I received all of these wonderful archival materials, but unfortunately, I was not able to integrate it into the essay because for yung the lack of time. But these materials are available if you are interested. I am going to share it with you. So ganun, no? So parang, it's like a continuing thing na parang a book naman kasi is never finished, I think. It's only, you know, you just end it, no? When you feel that it can be ended and can be shared with your readers, no? With some semblance of, you know, something whole in it, no? But otherwise, sabi nga sa akin na parang when a friend finished reading the book, she told me na parang humihingi ito ng follow-up essays on summer naman. Na parang sabi ko, ay hindi, baka i-reassign ako ng department. Mapunta na ako sa department. Anyway, yeah. So thank you for that question.
Thank you so much, Nimpo.
Oh, galing ng ano, ha? Galing ng students for joy, ha?
As a poet po, in writing, like, in writing in a different form po, like, did you struggle na kanang, does your poetic consciousness, perhaps, na kanang baka influence pa rin siya in writing in a different form? Parang yun.
Siguro kinausap mo sila. Ganito. Joke lang. Thank you so much for the questions. They're wonderful, no? I think one of the things that I consciously worked at when I was writing the essays is that for me not to sound academic. I wanted my essays to sound as if they were poetry being written in prose. Kasi I do not want to have that dichotomy na this is me, diba? As a poet, this is me as a... Kaya parang it really sounds more like a lyric, no? A lyric essay. And I didn't want it to be very long. No? Para may ano ba? Parang there's still a... pag mabasa na, there's still some sense na parang, ah, okay, tapos na, parang, diba? Yun. So yun lang ang ano ko, no, yung parang, and I was always trying to call, no, parang, or look at some metaphor that I could, ano. Hindi naman sa talagang naghahanap ako ng metaphor because the entire notion of weaving is really metaphoric, diba? Andiyan na siya, you don't even need to work it, no, parang andun na talaga. But there were things like, yung even the language, di ba, yung kalamragan, yung ano, all of these things were coming out as I was trying to write, ano, yung the book. And in a way, it's really working with debris, with the rubbles, di ba, of disaster. Kaya nga, ano, I mean, it was very heartwarming for some of my friends to write, no, yung their own messages, no, about the book na parang one friend told me na parang your language is very transfigurative daw, no, na parang writing from disaster can be very inspiring, no, parang, and I hope nga na that it had some kind of effect, no. Parang ang hirap talaga kasi parang yung our sense of yung disaster, di ba? Yung isang friend ko naman sabi, kasi talagang into theory siya, sabi niya, oh, Dina, this is the post-disaster eco-biography, yung mga ganyan. Kasi di ba, mahilig tayo yung sa mga term. Sabi ko, ah, ganun ba? Post-disaster eco-biography or eco-biography or what, no? But I realized we can never be post-disaster. We are, the fact that we are breathing, the fact that we are alive, it's always about uncertainty, no? It's always things happening to us, things happening on us, di ba? Now we cannot be post-disaster. As just right there, always in the midst of things.
Thank you so much for that, ma'am. Any other questions from the audience?
Hello, ma'am. Good afternoon po. Question ko lang po is, what do you hope readers will feel or think after reading your book po? Especially those people na galing mismo po doon sa place na sinulatan niyo po.
Thank you. In truth, no, when the book came out, kasi unang-una kinukulit ako ng NPDB. No, si Nenny Santa Romana Cruz, pag nagkikita kami, wherever, literary event or book festival, ang una niyang tatanong niya, asan na yung libro? Because she was the chair of the NBDB at that time, no, that the grant was awarded. So, finally, I said na before my sabbatical ends, no, I will come out with the, ano na, with the finished book. So, andyan na na. When it came out, I was so surprised with the reception of the book, no? So, yung, understandably, yung my friends in the Leyte Samar region, no? They offered yung to organize book events, yung book talks, no? And I was so touched by that kind of gesture kasi parang ang feeling ko is it's really saying that we are all in this together, that I heard your stories, that I am one with you, no? And that we are going to go forward, marching on, no, past any kind of disaster, no, that we are still going to experience, because this is, I think, the new normal na, no? You have such extreme heat, you have such extreme rain, typhoon, so. And of course, we all know, I don't know the, ano, of the terrain of Mindanao, no? But summer talaga is the typhoon path, no? Summer is the typhoon path, kaya parang in a way, they do not really have yung infrastructures that are like the infrastructures in other places, no? Like yung Iloilo, I think they have tall buildings, ganyan. In summer, you do not have that. Kasi nga parang baka hagipin lang yan ng ano, no? Ng mga bagyo, no? Yeah, so yung even yung sa in Basay, no, when I said yung I made a courtesy call with the mayor, and then yung the Katbalogan Arts Council, they emailed me and saying that they want to do a launch of the book on the eve of their fiesta, no? And I said, wow, yung talagang yung you realize you touch base with the community, no? Kasi for people, no, in summer, fiestas are a very big thing. Kasi that's when people come home from different parts, wherever they are, and then they do 1 week of festivities, kakain yan talaga, and they receive people, their neighbors or whoever, into their home, welcome them into their home. So, as I said, ano kaya gagawin ko sa buklong, kakanta ko, or what? But the mere gesture of receiving a book, no, as part of the fiesta, di ba? Parang sabi ko, aba, kakaibang experience ito. But it means that you've touched something very, ano, yung intimate, no, and I consider this now as community, ano, community work, cultural work, whatever, no. And then I have friends yun messaging me na parang it's inspiring in a way, no, kasi you're writing past, no, destruction, you're somehow parang there's hope, no, in the little that we have here. So yun lang, no. All that I really wanted was to comply with the NBTB grant. To comply with the NBTB grant, di ba? Pero yung mga ganito, di ba, these are plus points na talaga, no? And so many people helped along the way. For instance, yung sa printing ng book, that's also a friend from Nasal I worked with, and she made sure that the book will come out like a small coffee table book, no? So yun.
Thank you so much for that, ma'am. One more question from the students.
Oh yes, one last na, no, kasi yung book designer si ano Michael Balili, no. We were working, I was putting together the book with the text and with the visuals in mind. So yung finally yung itong this is the seawall that I was telling you about, no. I took the photo and yung the original one is just so ordinary, and then digital enhancement, and then yung tapos we came up with like 11 studies before I finally said this is it, ito yung cover na gusto ko. Kasi when the lower portion was digitally enhanced, I said, Michael, gusto ko ng kalamragan, gusto ko yung the brilliant ano sky after the storm, no? Put it there, bahala ka na, hindi ko alam kung paano mo gagawin, basta, no? So we had like back and forth 11 studies ng cover. And finally, I said, ayan na. And even yung sa, dito na yung mga nitty-gritty, eh, no? And even yung sa, ano, weaving Basay, it was first brown, eh. Habi ko, hindi, ang gusto ko yung, ano, kasi there is a river in Basay, it's called the Golden River. in its local name, it's Kadakaan River. And it has, yun nga, ang ano niya is Golden River. Kasi nga, there was supposed to be a bell, a golden bell, that was sunk into the, ano. So finally, sabi ko, parang i-gold mo. Habi niya, ma'am, sobra na po ito kasi wala po sa palit yung gold na gusto niyo. So sabi niya, ma'am, please let go of the manuscript na, otherwise you won't, ano, you won't finish with the, ano, with the book. So, yun.
Thank you so much for that, ma'am. Personally, I have some thoughts with the book cover. I won't be sharing that. Hindi, ma'am. It's a comment of hubris. I won't be sharing it, ma'am. Okay, so thank you so much for that, ma'am. One last question from the students before we end tayo sa faculty. One more question. About the faculty. Hindi, ma'am. How about the faculty this time? Wala sa students. Anyone like to ask something?
We're saving our questions because we're gonna be together later. Well, actually, my question was already asked by Josh. But I just wanna follow up on that question, maybe Dina. Because
first of all, it's great to see you again back in Ibi Mindanao. The last time we were together was in Samal.
And,
yeah, but we have been seeing each other on Zoom, right? For Carmi. Yeah, Carmi is one of Carmi's readers, and Carmi was writing about Lace as well. But for this one, I just want to hear, because Josh asked about your being a poet and transitioning to a different form. What does it feel like to now have a book that is in a different genre, and does it open up something?
Only a John Bengal would be able to hit it home.
does it open to another, you know, desire to write another book that is in nonfiction that is also poetry at the same time? I know that we feel something after we finish. Finally, I've known what it's like. But now that you have had like 4 books of poems, and now it's nonfiction, so it's like I want to hear what you've been going through.
Well, I mean, it's a
good question. I don't
turn it off. Hello. As I said, that's probably the best question to sum it all up, no? So yeah, 4 books of poetry. And, you know, each time that I write or finish a book of poetry, no? I always tell people that I cannot go back to even reading it, no? Kasi parang ang feeling ko, it's one thing that you have already released, no? Out of your system. But yes, no? To say really honestly, I feel that this is really one of my accomplishments, no? Because I am such an agonizing writer, no? And I feel that I do not have a good grasp of prose, I tell you. So I struggled with those doubts, actually, when I was writing the book. Over and above the fact that I was struggling with the fact that I am an interloper in the field of history, no? So finally, when this came out, no, and I just wanted for the initial copy to be around 50 copies lang, para what 49 I can give to NBTP, one I can keep as my own copy. No, but when it came out and then people were saying, wow, no, parang you've managed to, ano, buhay ka pa, no? Buhay ka pa, no? Yes, yung feeling ko na I do want to do more of yung nonfiction,